I guess almost everyone is watching this video on an LCD display. But have you ever thought how this LCD is actually made? I also don't know how. But we will find out together. To find it out, I have come to Shenzhen, China to a company called SpiderTech, which is one of the most popular LCD manufacturers in the world. They produce millions of displays every year. A display consists of multiple layers. The most important layer is liquid crystal, which is made by machines and in a closed environment. At this step, the LCD is nothing but liquid crystal sandwiched between two polarized sheets. There is no circuit or electronics to drive the LCD. So, at the next step, the display is placed in a conveyor belt. Then a robotic arm takes the LCD and first adds some ACF glue. And then installs an IC that drives the LCD. This process is known as COG, which stands for chip on glass. Now you can see the chip is installed on the glass of the right LCD, whereas the left one is without a chip. To check that the chip is installed properly or not, first they align the display properly and do some tests. If everything looks fine, then they attach the display flex cable with the LCD, for which first they add ACF, a kind of conductive adhesive, onto the LCD. Then they properly align the flex cable with the display and fix it. After that, they add some glue on the connector for the flex cable to stay in its position and cure it using UV light. Now, as the display is ready, so it's time to add the digitizer, commonly known as touchscreen panel. But to join them together, we definitely need some clear adhesive. Here comes OCA. It is an optically transparent adhesive film used to combine the LCD with the touch panel. For this process, a clean and class 100 dustproof room is needed. To maintain the cleanliness, they use HEPA filter, a kind of air filter, and humidifier. To attach the OCA, one has to remove the protective film from the touch panel and put it in the given place, after which OCA is placed on it and a mechanical roller is rolled over it. Now it's time to add the display with it. Here, the LCD panel and the touch panel is put in the given place. After that, they press the ready button, which leads the whole process to the joining stage. After joining, few air bubble remains in it. To remove that, the display is kept inside a bubble eliminating chamber. Which provides 0.5 megapascal pressure that removes all the air bubble. After 10 minutes, a person takes out the lot and checks whether any bubble is left or not. If everything goes right, then the digitizer and the display connector is joined back to back. After joining, they again test it for any faulty results and whether the touch function is properly working or not. Now it's time to add the frame. So first, they add some glue on the side of the display and attach it with the frame. To fix it, the display is placed along with the frame. After that, it is placed in a column and is pressed using hydraulic press. After this, the display is detached and WCG backlight is added in it and soldered with the display, which provides light to the display. Finally, they test everything once again, like the 3D touch, capacitive touch, and presence of scratches. If everything goes right, then the display is sent to a place where a machine automatically covers the display with a screen guard. After this, the display is polished to remove any kind of marks or fingerprints. Now it is ready to hit the market. Since in this aggressive world where everywhere there is a competition, comparing with the local competitor is very essential. So after every batch, they compare it with their competitor and check whether their display is top-notch or not. SpiderTech makes sure their display is better in color, brightness, viewing angle, and touch response than their competitors. Here are the test results using Spider 5 machine. Their displays have 360-degree multi-view polarizer, which enable a user to see even using a sunglass. The display also fits perfectly in iPhones. Thank you for watching this video. How do you find it? Let me know in the comment section below. So that's it for now. See you in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.